Okay, great.
Okay, so since today's class is focused on balance, yes, Leo's gonna be joining us. I feel like every class we're gonna have a cat here. So, since we are in Libra season, the focus of this class today is going to be balance. Everything, pretty much every part. So we are gonna start with alternate nostril breathing, right? So take your right hand and isolate the pointer fingers. So you kind of have like an L shape with your two hands. These, your pinky and your ring finger are down and these three are up. So you're gonna put this hand, you're gonna put your two fingers on your temples, right? Your thumb will close off your right nostril and your ring finger will close off your left nostril. So just practice that, closing off each side of your nostrils in this hand position, right? So this is called alternate nostril breathing. And this is supposed to bring balance to both sides of your mind. It's an entry level breathing exercise, right? So we're gonna do breathing exercises. You know, you have to kind of have to start slow. So we're gonna inhale for 4 seconds and exhale for 8 seconds with that same hand position. So two fingers on the forehead, your thumb will close off your right nostril and your ring finger will close off your left nostril. So we're gonna do this together, right? So close off your left nostril and inhale through your right for 4 seconds. All right, so we're starting. 1, 2, 3, 4, inhale, close off the right, hold for 2, open your left, exhale for 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now you're gonna inhale on your left and exhale on the right this time, right? So inhale for 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, close off your left, exhale through the right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Close off your right side.
Leo, please, I understand, okay.
And then you're gonna do it at your own pace. So I'm gonna do it with you guys. Do it for 2 more rounds, okay? 2 more rounds of alternate nostril breathing and then we'll start our yoga sequence. Okay, so I'm doing it with you. Inhale through the right. Exhale through the left. That was 1 round. We're gonna do it for another. Close it off, exhale through your left. Inhale through the left. Close off the left, exhale through the right. And that is our alternate nostril breathing. You can do that anytime. Anytime you feel like you need like a minute. I definitely needed that minute because I was so frustrated with my sound. So what time is it? It's 10:48 and we're gonna get started. So just sit in your most comfortable seat. It could be cross leg, it could be straight leg, it doesn't matter. And we're going to start with neck rolls. So roll your neck to the right side. Remember, as you're going around the back, you want to inhale. When you come around the front, you want to exhale. Inhale your head back. Exhale forward. Inhale your head back. Exhale forward. And I'm gonna go counterclockwise or the other direction. So roll that head back, inhale. Exhale around the front. Inhale. Exhale around the front. Excuse me. Inhale. Exhale around the front. Inhale your head straight back to center. And now we're gonna take some seated spinal twists. So raise your right arm, place it behind you. Your left hand will go on your right knee and we're in a twist. So while you're here, inhale, straighten your back. Exhale, deepen the twist. Inhale, straighten. Exhale, deepen. Inhale, straighten. Exhale, deepen. Inhale, back to center. And we're gonna do the same thing on our left side. So take your left hand, place it behind you. Your right hand goes on your left knee. And we're in that twist. Inhale, straight, lengthen your spine. Exhale, deepen your twist. Inhale, lengthen your spine. Exhale, deepen your twist. Last round of breath. Inhale, lengthen your spine. Exhale, deepen your twist. Inhale, back to center. And we can change the crossing of your legs if they're crossed. I just kind of confused me. I think this was crossed. Okay, and we are going to do some cat-cows in this position. So we want to exhale, round your spine. Inhale, straighten. Perhaps this you can see me better on the side. So inhale round, exhale round. Inhale, arch. Exhale round. Inhale, arch. It's gonna be the last round. Exhale round. Inhale, arch. And do your next exhale, make your way to your back. I'm gonna move a little closer. Okay, so while you're on your back, wait, what are you guys saying? Okay, you can hear me. Great. Okay, so while you're on your back, you wanna grab your strap, or you can use your shirt. If you have on pants, you can use your pants. You can use whatever you have nearby that will basically help you hold your leg up in these next positions, okay? So, like I said, make your way onto your back. And we're gonna start with our right leg. Kind of like something that we did last week, just with a little bit more assistance. So bring your leg into your strap. And you're bringing it as close. This is called hand to toe pose, reclined hand to toe. So, we're basically stretching the hamstrings in preparation for all the balancing poses that we are going to embark on today. So, and if you don't have a strap, you can use your hands. Like, you don't need a strap, just grab onto wherever you can, just not the back of your knee. Okay, either above the knee or below the knee. All right, so a few more breaths here.
And then we're gonna take that leg and let it out to the side. So you are this stretching your inner thigh. Again, if you don't have a strap, you can just hold your leg like this. Like this, right? Or up here. You want to go out as far as you can. Keep your left leg grounded to the floor. Either you can have your knee bent or you can straighten it out. Yes, cats love feet. They want to smell anything that they can, right?
So see how far out you can let your leg go without, you know, causing too much tension. And on your next inhale, bring your leg to center. And we're gonna cross it over our bodies, right? You're still holding, you still have your strap. Your left leg is definitely straight in this position. Otherwise, you wouldn't be able to get into it. Right? So you still have your strap. If there's no strap, you just support with your hand. And while you're here, you're stretching across the body, your shoulders should both be on the ground. So if your leg is reaching the floor, but your shoulder is off the ground, no, it's more important for your shoulders to both be on the ground. All right. Back to center, inhale, back to center. And we're gonna switch legs. Okay, so we're on our left side now. And we are stretching. You can have your right leg either bent or straight. And remember, you're always taking deep breaths. Deep inhales, deep exhales. Yoga is mainly about the breath. If you can't breathe, then you need to adjust. Also, while you're here, you wanna try to engage your thigh muscles so you can protect your knee. Okay, so we're gonna take this out to the side. Upper thigh. I think it's called the quad. And on your next inhale, we're bringing it back to center. Straighten out your right leg. And then cross that leg over your body. So to the right side, your left leg is on your right side, crossing over. Remember again, both your shoulders should be on the ground, on your mat, wherever you may be. It's also a great morning stretch. Like, if you're feeling stiff on the wake up, those three leg stretches, whether you have a strap or not, are really gonna set you up nice. All right, two more breaths here. And on your next inhale, back to center, release your leg from your strap. And we're gonna roll up
to a seated position. So our next move is going to be Balasana. And I have to admit that this is not one of my favorite poses, but we are in the spirit of balancing since we're in Libra season. So we're just gonna do it, okay? So Balasana or boat pose, right? So you wanna have your back straight from jump. This is where we are, right? While we're here, bring your feet together, lift one foot. See how that feels. Lift another foot, right? Look at me, I'm already like off kilter. So you can keep your hands behind your knees. You can have your arms up. I will keep my arms behind my knees. And we're gonna take 4 deep breaths here, right? Okay. And while you're breathing, you kind of want it to sound like the ocean. So you need that breath to come from the back of your throat. Kind of like a, but with your mouth closed. That was breath 3 for anybody who's counting. And this is our last breath. Inhale. Exhale, bring those feet down. Straighten out your legs and forward fold. Remember, you can reach down as far as is safe for your lower back. And remember, you're always leading with your chest. We're gonna lean back and windshield wiper our knees from side to side. I don't know about you guys, but I felt that in my lower abs. We are gonna do another round, so just mentally prepare for that. Okay, and next time you bring your knees to center, we're gonna set up for Balasana again, boat pose, right? Starting with a straight back. Knees bent. Test it out with one foot. We're here. And then the other foot. See how the toes are pointed? This is no good. You're kind of like walking. But you want to keep your toes pointed. That helps you balance. At least it helps me balance. Or your feet can, like, you mean, you know, it doesn't have to be all the way up. The full expression is like this, but we're not there yet. 2 more breaths here, guys, okay? Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. All right, bring the feet down. And now let's make our way to tabletop. Okay, so while we're here, well, make your way to tabletop and rotate your hips to the right. So we're kind of going in a circle, bring it around, stretching out the front of that body. Right, since we just did an ab exercise, you guys should be warm. Now take your circles counterclockwise or the opposite direction. Remember, you're always breathing. The last circle, and meet me back in tabletop. All right, so I forgot what this is called, but we are going to do another balancing pose, right? So extend your right foot. You want your toes pointing to the ground, to the floor, hips are square. Extend your left hand. Breathe here. Two more breaths. One more breath. And on your next exhale, we're gonna bring our elbow to our knee. One. Extend. Next one. Two. Three, elbow to knee. Make sure they touch. Four, elbow to knee. Last one, elbow to knee. Extend, back to tabletop. Now here we're gonna hit a cat-cow. Inhale, arch your spine. Exhale, round. Inhale, arch. I forgot to start my watch. Exhale, round. Inhale, arch. Exhale, round. And then we're gonna go on the next side. So extend your left leg. And extend your right arm. We'll stay here for three breaths. Inhale. Exhale, one. Last breath, last round of breath. And on your next exhale, you're gonna bring your elbow to your knee. Extend, inhale out, exhale, elbow to knee. Inhale, extend, exhale, elbow to knee. Inhale, extend, exhale, elbow to knee. Inhale, last round. Exhale, elbow to knee. Inhale, back to tabletop. And again, we're gonna hit our cat-cow. Inhale. Exhale, arch your spine. Inhale, arch, exhale, round. Exhale, round. Inhale, arch. Exhale, round. And next, we're going to do our lunges. We're starting our standing sequence, okay, guys? All right, so you wanna bring your right, well, you can extend your right leg and bring it in between your hands. Remember what we talked about as far as knee over ankle. You don't want to go past your knee too much. Like, you can a little bit, but the general rule is that they should be stacked. And then also see how my knee, I'm not on my knee like this. I'm in front of it. And it's really just like a feeling. Obviously you can see it, but it's really a feeling. So while we're here, we're gonna have our arms up. This is our low lunge. We're taking three breaths here. Last round of breath. Exhale, bring your arms down to the sides of your feet. Extend your right leg back. We're in a runner's lunge. You can lift your toes. And come down as far as you can. The more your hip is back, the more you'll feel the stretch, like in the back of your leg. Like, I feel it all in here, right? And we can take this into a flow. Inhale, arms up into low lunge. Exhale, back into runner's lunge. Inhale, low lunge. Exhale, runner's lunge. Inhale, low lunge. Now from here, pay attention. We're gonna bring your left knee in a little bit. And then we're gonna bring our right leg, well, plant your left hand down, bring your right foot back. And we are open, your right foot should be flat. Like you're gonna walk on the wall behind you. Right arm up to the sky. We are in a side plank. Exhale, come back to a tabletop. Now we're gonna do the same thing on the other side. So inhale your left leg back. Exhale, left leg between your hands. And we are in a low lunge. Remember our lunges, your legs, your knee is in line with your hip. Not off on the side like this, not like this. We are straight. We're here for 3 more breaths. Deep inhales, deep exhales. Inhale, exhale. Last round of breath. Exhale, bring your arms down to the sides. And we're gonna go into our runner's lunge. And you want your hips to be even here as well. And what I mean by that is we're straight here. We're not, you know, or like this. This is also a great split. Like if you want to do a split, I'm practicing splits right now, so I do these all the time. And then, so we're gonna take this into a lunge, into our flow. So inhale, low lunge. Exhale, runner's lunge. Inhale, low lunge. Exhale, runner's lunge. Inhale, low lunge. If you need to, bring your right knee in a little bit. Plant your right hand on the floor. Left hand goes up. Left foot floats up in the back. You can use your back foot as kind of like an anchor. It doesn't have to be straight. It can be out to the side a little bit. And we'll stay here for another 2 breaths. Last round of breath. On your next exhale, we're gonna come back to tabletop. And you can enter child's pose. This is your resting pose. You can come here anytime. Anytime you want. I'm telling you now. This might get a little intense. You can come right here. And I won't even know. All right, let's take a couple more breaths here. While we prepare for our standing series. All right, inhale, up to down dog. This is our first down dog of the day. And you just want to pedal your feet. Remember, your hands need to be wide. Your front, your pointer and your thumb should make an L shape. So it should be like this and then this. Your hands will be shoulder width apart. And they say to try and make your elbows, like turn your elbows in. So this is what turning your elbows in looks like. Like I should see your elbow, or you should see your elbow crease, right? All right, so on your next inhale, extend your right leg back. Exhale, place your right foot in between your hands, and we are in warrior one. Your back foot should be at a 45 degree angle. And your front should be, your front knee is kind of like a lunge, right? And we're gonna exhale, back to down dog. Pedal out the feet. Inhale your left leg back. Exhale, plant your left foot between your hands. We're in warrior one. And your arms are up. I know you guys can't see my arms. I'm gonna figure that out. Right, exhale. Step back to plank. Now you can do knees, chest, chin, into cobra. Or you can do the other vinyasa, which is plank, chaturanga, up dog. You can come back into child pose or down dog. And we're hanging out right here for a few seconds. Believe it or not, down dog is a resting pose. A lot of people, especially beginners, feel like it's a lie, but you'll get there. All right, so from here, bend your knees, kind of like a frog. Bend them two more times. One more time. And then I want you to hop to the top of your mat. Put your feet together about 2 fists width apart. And you're in your forward fold. We're here for a couple seconds. And your forward fold, you don't want to lock your knees out. You want to be, you know, be able to bounce if you need to. In any of our standing poses, you will not need to lock out your knees. Because you need an escape plan. And those will usually be your knees. All right, so inhale up to straight back. Well, into a mountain pose. Tadasana, arms up to the sky. Exhale, hands heart in front of heart center. Let me bring this up. So just stand in Tadasana for now. Enjoy this couple seconds break while I set my camera up better. Oop. I hope y'all are sweating because as you can see, I am drenched. All right. I don't even know if that's better, but that's where we are. All right, so we should be here. Hands in the heart center. And then exhale, arms up.
Well, inhale, arms up. Exhale, back into a forward fold, flat back. Boom. And step back into your down dog. Excuse me, though. It's also a great shoulder, okay, you can still take it. This is also a great shoulder stretch. All right, so we're gonna extend our left leg, our right leg back, and you wanna open your hip, right? So your knee is kind of facing, is up towards the sky. And on your next exhale, we're gonna bring that foot between the hands. Right, just like a lunge, but this time we are in warrior two. So your back foot is going to be parallel to the back of your mat. Your front foot is facing the front of your body. Arms out to the sides, and you're gazing over your middle finger. This is our warrior two. Definitely different from warrior one. Exhale, place your right forearm on your left, on your right knee. Your left hand is gonna come up and over your ear. If you want a deeper stretch, you can go, you can reach your hand down to the floor. Feel free to look up at your arm, or you can look down at the floor, whichever one is easier. Now we're gonna straighten out that front leg. Remember our triangle pose? So you're coming up out of your hip. Actually, let's do that differently. So come back into warrior two. Straighten your front leg. And then we're extending like this. And when you can't go any further, you can't reach any further, that's when you wanna tip over to the side. And this is our triangle pose. Triangle has been one of my most difficult poses, but now that I'm strong enough, I wouldn't say I love it, but you know, I'm more open to doing it. All right, then we're gonna come back into our warrior two, and you're gonna cartwheel your hands back to the floor, down to the floor, into a plank. So extend your right foot back, we're in a plank. Stay here for a couple seconds. Leo, you're gonna get crushed, buddy. I know. All right, so you can either knees, chest, chin, chaturanga. Knees, chest, chin, cobra. Or you can hit your plank into up dog. Exhale, back to down dog. Right, same thing on the left side. We're lifting our left leg and we're opening that hip. Hopefully you can see it better on this side. That's what I mean by an open hip. Leo, please. Right? You can circle that hip. And on your next exhale, put your left foot between your hands. Cartwheel your arms up. Remember your back foot. This should be your right foot. We're on the left side. You should be parallel to the back of your mat. Your front knee is over your ankle. Your gaze is over your middle finger. And your arms are out like airplanes. This is warrior two. Couple breaths here. On your next exhale, your left elbow comes to your left knee. Your right arm is up and over your ear. So your chest is open here. Your chest is very open. You don't wanna like this, no. We're open and over, right?
If you need something deeper, you can let your elbow go and reach that left hand down to the floor. Your chest is still open. I'm taking a lot of deep breaths here. Slow. Remember, ocean sounding breaths. It needs to come from the back of your throat. All right, inhale up to warrior two. Straighten out your front leg. Extend forward with your left hand until you can't anymore. And drop your left arm. Your right arm is straight up above. You can look up, you can look down. If you need assistance, you can lightly touch your shin. Lightly, your shin, not your knee. Because that's where you get, that's how you cause injuries, right? All right, now bend that front knee. Bring your arms back into warrior two. And then we're going to cartwheel our arms down and go into our vinyasa flow, either knees, chest, chin, or chaturanga to up dog. And we're gonna come back into child's pose
for a little rest.
And in these final rounds, we are gonna need our blocks, or you might need your block. I'm not gonna say you will need your block, but you might need your block. Your blocks. So those first two sequences, y'all should still be child's pose. Those first two sequences that we did, I'm gonna combine them. Feel free to open a window like I did. All right, so from child's pose, we are, this is also gonna move a little quicker because we're kind of familiar with the moves by now. So in child's pose, come up to down dog. Inhale, right leg back. Exhale, right foot between the hands. We are in a high lunge this time.
High lunge.
Exhale, left hand down. High lunge twist. Right arm up. Now, next we're going to do a side plank. Remember earlier we were here, knee down, leg up. But from here, you can, if you want to stay with knee down, you can. Or you can come to a full side plank. Right? You can either use your foot, you can stack your feet on top of each other. Or, you know, make them scissor. All right. Back to plank.
Down dog. Exhale, right leg back.
Inhale, hands between the feet. We're in our warrior two. Warrior two to down to extended side angle. Knee to elbow, arm overhead, or your hand is on the floor. Inhale, warrior two. Exhale, extend your front leg, triangle pose. Reach, reach, reach. Bend over. Now, from here, we are going to enter half, well, no. Actually, let's go back to warrior two. From here, we're gonna do half moon pose. You can watch if you need to. So you're gonna launch off your back foot, which is your left foot, right? This is half moon. I'm using my block. Block here. Makes it a lot easier. Whoa. Balancing, remember? Everyone should be in half moon. Take a couple breaths here to help you arch your foot like you're gonna walk on the wall behind you. Keep your foot flat. Your standing leg is strong and your knee is not locked out, because if you fall, you need to be able to bend your knee to save yourself, right? All right, so to dislodge from our warrior half moon pose, just let that back foot back. And we're back into warrior two. Flip that front hand, reverse warrior. Your back hand is on your back thigh. Or you can take your back hand and wrap it behind you for a bind, right? Exhale, warrior two. And we're hitting our vinyasa. So knees, chest, chin, or plank, chaturanga, up dog. Exhale, down dog. And we're going on to the next side. Don't worry, this is our last side before we can lay down, okay? All right, so extend your left leg back and you're opening the hip. Exhale, left foot between your hands, and we're in a low lunge. I mean, we're in a high lunge. Woo! This is our high lunge. Stay here for a couple seconds. I am like sweating bullets. I hope y'all are sweating bullets too, because woo! All right. We're gonna go into our lunge twist. So right arm down, left arm up. And you can either take your assisted side angle, I mean your assisted side plank, which is knee down, right, like this. Or come straight back, we're in our sides. This is our side plank. When you think about it, this is kind of like a half moon, right? Back to plank. Down dog. 2 seconds rest. Extend your left leg back. Bring it between your hands and warrior two. Your back foot is parallel to the back of your mat. Your gaze is over your middle finger. Exhale, extend the side angle. Elbow to knee. Your right hand is over your, is going over your ear. Your chest is open. And you're not leaning into your shoulder either, like this. You're like this. All right, exhale, back to warrior two. Straighten out your front leg for triangle pose. Reach forward, reach, 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 reach. Drop down. We're in triangle pose. Like I said, you can, you know, you should ultimately be able to release your bottom hand, but if you can't, you know, just use your shin for a little extra support. All right, coming out of warrior two. And, well, coming back to warrior two. And then we are going into half moon again. So, launch off your back foot. Your left hand is either on the floor or on a block. Mine is on a block today. Whoa. Okay, clearly my left side sucks, but that's okay. I'm gonna stay here for a couple more breaths. Woo! All right, and then fall back into your warrior two. and cartwheel your hands down for your vinyasa, whether that be knees, chest, chin, or chaturanga, chaturanga to up dog. And we're gonna hit child pose. You know, I am so sweaty. Okay. Let me see what time it is. It's 11:34. We started like 11:40 or something. So they're gonna cut me off soon. All right, so let's make our way to our backs. I'm gonna
bring us back to the floor.
Okay.
Oh, wait, actually. Oh, yeah, no. We can do, let's do a reclined pigeon. Because I'm sure everyone's tired of being, of standing. So, for reclined pigeon, this is where we got cut off last week too. We are going to bring our right foot, our right ankle over the left knee. So this is like a figure four. They also like to call it, excuse me. So here, and then you're gonna lift your left leg, your left knee rather, and wrap your hand around the back of your thigh. This is a reclined pigeon pose. So if you find that regular pigeon hurts, whether it be like your knee or, you know, anything else, you can just take pigeon this way. We'll take a couple breaths here. And then your next exhale, bring your whole pigeon to the left. So, stay in that pigeon pose. Well, yeah. All right, so grab onto your right ankle, your top ankle. So this would be the one. Hey, Rocky. And if you can, try to reach your bottom foot. I can't right now, but some of you might be able to. This is a stretch. Stretching the outer hips. This is also somewhere that your strap can come in at. Feel it all here. Hopefully you guys do too. All right, so we're gonna come back up to center. I'm gonna do the same thing on the other side. So, pigeon pose, reclined pigeon, ankle over knee. Your left ankle over your right knee. This is level one. If this feels fine here, then just stay. The rest of us will lift our right leg. And we're gonna bring that foot over to the side.
So grab your left foot, the top, well, your left ankle,
and try to bring that bottom ankle
or foot to reach your back arm. Your back hand.
Okay, we have a minute left. So that's pretty much the end. We're gonna come back to center. You can hit a little happy baby.
Rock from side to side. You should also feel in your hamstrings. And then for the next like a minute or two, you want to seal your practice by laying in Shavasana, which is corpse pose. You literally do nothing except lay